Gliding effortlessly through the dark waters, full of precious treasures and secrets beneath the surface, cargo submarines are a wonder to behold. These mysterious deep-sea creatures are a symbol of human innovation and determination, pushing the boundaries of what is possible and venturing into uncharted territories. From the depths of the ocean to the depths of human innovation, cargo submarines have always captured our imagination. These underwater vessels are more than just machines. They represent humanity's curiosity and drive to explore the unknown. Join us as we dive into the history and evolution of cargo submarines, discover how these incredible machines have pushed the boundaries of what is possible, and continue to inspire us to reach new heights of creativity and understanding. But that's not all. We'll also look into their future potential and their role in the energy industry. So put on your diving gear and let's get started. The advent of cargo submarines can be traced back to the early 20th century. One of the first cargo submarines was the USS Holland, developed by John P. Holland in the late 1890s. The USS Holland was the first commissioned submarine in the United States Navy. It was primarily used for transportation, reconnaissance, and sabotage. During World War I, cargo submarines were used to transport goods and troops to and from war zones. Submarines were also used to conduct espionage and sabotage operations. In the early 1920s and 1930s, several cargo submarine projects were developed and tested, including the German Deutschland-class submarines used to transport goods between Germany and the United States during the interwar period. As the world stood on the brink of war in the 1930s, nations scrambled to develop new technologies and weapons to gain an edge in the coming conflict. One of these technologies was the submarine. These underwater vessels, once used primarily for transportation and reconnaissance, were now adapted for a new role: warfare. As the Second World War broke out, submarines from all nations were thrown into the fray, playing a crucial role in the conflict that would shape the world for decades to come. Cargo submarines were particularly useful during World War II. These submersible cargo ships were used to transport supplies and troops to and from war zones. Submarines were not only used for transportation, but also for espionage and sabotage. After World War II, the United States and the Soviet Union both invested heavily in submarines for strategic and military purposes. However, cargo submarines were not a priority. The development of container ships, which could carry much larger loads, made cargo submarines obsolete. Additionally, the cost of maintaining and operating a cargo submarine was much higher than a traditional surface ship. With the introduction of container ships, the cargo industry shifted towards them, and cargo submarines were no longer needed. Cargo submarines are truly a symbol of human curiosity and creativity. They are a representation of our desire to understand and explore our world. But how does an underwater vessel, with such a fascinating history, just simply disappear from the shipping industry? After World War II, most countries shifted their focus to developing submarines for military use rather than cargo use due to the Cold War arms race between the United States and the Soviet Union. This led to the development of submarines for strategic and military purposes only. Gradually, cargo submarines began to be phased out by the advancement of other technologies in shipping. For example, the development of container ships, which could carry much larger loads, made cargo submarines obsolete in the shipping industry. Additionally, satellite technology and GPS advancements have made it easier to navigate and track surface ships, reducing the need for cargo submarines. Building and maintaining cargo submarines is also pretty complex and expensive, and not many companies can afford such high costs. Additionally, a cargo submarine's maintenance and operating costs are much higher than those of a traditional surface ship. Another reason why we are beginning to see fewer and fewer cargo submarines is their inherent limited capabilities. Compared to surface ships, cargo submarines can only operate in a limited depth range. They cannot navigate in shallow waters or bad weather conditions. This makes them less versatile and less useful for the shipping industry. Safety concerns and the potential for accidents and incidents with cargo submarines make them less attractive for commercial use. These combined factors have led to cargo submarines becoming less common in recent times. However, it's worth noting that cargo submarines still have a lot of potential for the future, especially in deep sea mining, energy extraction, scientific research, and underwater tourism. In recent years, there has been renewed interest in these underwater vessels. With the rising demand for energy and the increasing difficulty of extracting oil and gas from beneath the Earth's surface, cargo submarines have found a new use as underwater oil drilling platforms. These submarines can be equipped with drilling equipment to extract oil and gas from beneath the ocean floor. With the increasing demand for precious metals and minerals, more companies are looking for ways to extract them from the ocean floor. Cargo submarines can be equipped with mining equipment and be used to extract valuable minerals from the seabed. The deep sea is still largely unexplored. Cargo submarines can be used to study marine life and climate change's impact on the ocean. Submarines can be equipped with cameras and other scientific equipment to collect data and samples from the deep sea. Embarking on a cargo submarine journey is like embarking on a journey to the unknown. It's a chance to discover new worlds and uncover the secrets of the deep. It's a chance to experience the beauty and wonder of the ocean in a way that few people ever will. This is why underwater tourism is another potential use for cargo submarines. With the development of underwater habitats and technologies, cargo submarines can be converted into luxury submarines for tourists to explore the deep sea. This can be a unique and exciting way for people to experience the ocean and its inhabitants. There have also been several successful cargo submarine projects that are being developed for deep sea mining and energy extraction. For example, the Deep Green Company is developing a cargo submarine that will be used to extract metals and minerals from the ocean floor. The submarine will be equipped with mining equipment that will be used to extract valuable minerals from the seabed. Another example is Blue Nautic, a French company that is developing a cargo submarine to extract cobalt and other metals from the ocean floor. The submarine will be able to dive to depths of 6,000 meters and will be equipped with mining equipment that will be used to extract the metals from the seabed. All these projects have been successful in their own way, proving the potential and value of cargo submarine technology and showing that there is still a lot of potential for the future of cargo submarines. Unfortunately, there have also been several failed cargo submarine projects in recent times. One of the most notable examples is the Cyclops. The Cyclops was a cargo submarine developed by the submersible company Noitco Research. It was intended to be used for deep sea mining, however, the project was eventually abandoned due to technical difficulties and high costs. Another example is the Deep Flight Super Falcon, a luxury cargo submarine developed by the company Deep Flight. The project was abandoned after the company ran out of funds and could not secure additional investment. A more recent example is the development of a Russian cargo submarine project for the Arctic, designed to transport goods under the Arctic ice. However, the project was halted due to a lack of funding and government support and the project's high cost. These failed projects don't mean the end of cargo submarine technology. Innovation and technology development often have setbacks, but that doesn't mean the idea is not viable or valuable. These projects have provided valuable information and experience for future cargo submarine developments. Cargo submarines may have fallen out of use in the shipping industry, but they still have a lot of potential for the future. From mining and extraction to scientific research and underwater tourism, cargo submarines have a lot of possibilities. It's always fascinating to see how technology develops and changes over time, and cargo submarines are a perfect example of that. So the next time you're out on a boat and see a submarine, just remember it might not be carrying cargo. It might be drilling for oil or studying marine life.